The Pro Mod Drag Racing Series, race number 6 of 10 today from Thunder Valley at Bristol Dragway in Bristol, Tennessee, as there are now 4 drivers left in the field. 3 of them have won, only one has not, and it is the driver of the Road Rage Machine, Leah Pruitt-Leduc. You see right there. In fact, this is only her 2nd race on the tour, but already she's starting to make some veteran-like moves after coming back following that English Town crash. Here are the Pro Mod ladders as we move into the semis. Callum Belushi will pick his lane against Danny Rowe. And remember, that's a big points matchup, 1 and 2. And it is the ladies on the racetrack right now, where Melanie, by a 1/1000th of a second, picks her lane.
Well, you talk about the teammates there, one in a turbocharged car out of Melanie Troxell, supercharged car out of Leah Pruitt-Leduc. Leah's, that's the former car that Melanie was driving before she stepped over into Roger Burgess's turbocharged car. Keep a scorecard. You got, it's hard to keep track of all these cars that Roger Burgess has, but it's been a good move up to this point, as both of these drivers have an excellent shot at winning today.
Let's not forget about stat guy, Lewis Bloom.
I asked Leah if she's ever raced another female in drag racing. She said back in the day when she raced juniors, never in nostalgia. Funny car, she never raced Mindy Fry, of all people.
Oh, that's very interesting indeed. Of course, Leah trying to do it for all the guys at the R2B2 shop who put her car back together following that net accident in Englishtown.
Wow, Leah was doing some driving there.
It's going to be Melanie Troxell, courtesy of the 597, 252 miles an hour, going to her 4th final. Bob Newberry, team owner Roger Burgess, you see right there, who told me just a moment ago, has absolutely no soreness following that accident, other than the left heel.
That is pretty much amazing, but Melanie also did an amazing job. 2/100 of a second advantage off of the start line. Very good reaction. I remember her first race in Englishtown, she really struggled getting off the line. She was dead late, but we knew she was going to figure that out and come right around, and she looks awfully good at another shot of getting a win here today.
And with that performance, Melanie Troxell should probably make her way up into the top 10, positions 3 through 10.